This is how to make a Sapphire hotspots transition on Premiere Pro. These are my clips, which have already been time remapped. The very first thing I'm going to do is head over to my project tab, right click, new item, adjustment layer, and click OK. I'm going to place this in between my clips and make them 10 frames long for each side, so 5, 10, and I'm just going to extend this. Same goes for the other side, so I'm just going to duplicate it. If you are using a higher frame rate sequence, so I'm using 24, therefore 10 frames on both sides works pretty well. But if you're using 30, for example, then you might want to go for 12 frames or even 15. Next, you want to add the hotspots effect. So first adjustment layer, head into effect controls, and we're going to keyframe the blur input and also the threshold. Set the threshold to 0 at the start, so 0 for both. And we're going to head to the final frame, increase the blur input to an amount that you like. So I think 10 is a decent amount of blur, and the threshold, just like blur, it depends on your clip. So something like 0.5 works fine for me. However, you might want to go for something like 0.75 or even 1. Next, I'm going to graph it towards the right. So open up both graphs for the blur input and the threshold. I'm going to head to the very start. I'm going to grab the handle for the first keyframe here and pull it. Also, make sure to watch the velocity. So this one should not dip below 0. So I'm just going to pull it all the way to the left and drag it down until it reaches, okay, 1.4 should be okay. Same goes for the other one. So down here for the threshold, gonna pull it to the right and make sure it reaches 0, or at least around 0. So that's fine. So far it looks like this, and we're just gonna repeat this but in reverse for the second adjustment layer. So add on hotspots once again, effect controls, keyframe the blur input and threshold. So we're going to set this to 10 at the beginning, and the threshold, I'm just going to go for 0.75. Head to the last frame, I'm going to decrease the blur amount to 0 and the threshold to 0. Open up both of these graphs and we're going to graph it to the left. So just head one frame back from your keyframes, and just like before, we're going to use the velocity to help us. So I'm going to grab this handle, pull it to the left, and make sure that it doesn't go above 0. So it should be a negative value that is close to 0. Something like negative 4.1 is okay. The closer it is, the better. So let's see. Okay, negative 0.7. Perfect. I'll let go. Repeat with the other graph. So I'm going to pull it to the left. Make sure it's close to 0. Negative 0.1. Perfect. Now, let's play it back. And there you go. Let's improve this a little bit more. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, head to my first adjustment layer and tighten up these keyframes. So grab the handle for the second one and just pull it up nice and close to the edge, like so. And the same goes for the bottom one. And I'm going to repeat this with the first keyframes on the second adjustment layer. So I'm going to grab it and pull it down instead of up, like so. So just copy what I am doing. And if for some reason you can't move these graphs, all you can do is push these forward and it should work, then just push them back. Now let's play it back from the very start. This is what it looks like, which is perfect. Let me know in the comments below what Sapphire effects I should cover next. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace.